Good morning to you guys. It's early. It's like 7:30. We're getting an early start like we were talking about. Just really quick though, we're gonna grab breakfast out dining room. Emily's out there now, but I want to show you what you couldn't see last night. It's only supposed to be like 10% chance of rain today and tomorrow. So anyhow, this is our view from the B&B. I've had worse views. All right, let me go check where Emily's at, and we're gonna eat, and then we'll be on our way. And it smells good.
It does smell good. Hi, guys. Good morning.
Look at that.
She's very sweet. She said there's a little bit of salt and pepper, and if you want more, just ask.
They've been really, really nice here.
Also, come to Ireland for their orange juice. This stuff is like literal just squeezed oranges. It's so good.
Even like the cheap stuff we've had from just the regular supermarket has been better than any apple or orange juice I've ever had. We're from Florida. Freaking oranges there. Like, USA, what are you doing?
Hi.
We are on the road, bright and early. Well, cloudy and early.
Yeah. We are starting with the Skellig Ring.
Yes, we are driving Skellig Ring Road.
We are not going the right
Google
way.
Google it. We're not going the right way.
No.
What? We're not going Skellig Ring Road.
This is wrong.
We need to turn around?
Yeah.
All right. We're turning around and then we're going Skellig Ring Road. We are on Skellig Ring Road.
Back on track. And it is a sight.
It's a
I didn't sight.
Want
to say beautiful.
We are surrounded by sights.
There are a lot of sights.
Literal surrounded, like it's everywhere.
Yeah.
Good news though, weather can change here really, really quickly, and the forecast is always just kind of up in the air. Kind of like Florida. But so far, today and tomorrow look really good. So Star Wars is still on track.
Hopefully. I had a dream last night.
Don't say it.
You didn't want to go.
Oh, that's not true.
You weren't feeling good, and so you told me that they had canceled it, but they didn't really cancel it. You just weren't feeling good.
Really?
Yeah. And I was like, oh, how rude.
I feel like if I had the plague tomorrow, I would still go.
Oh, no. That's why I was like, what do you mean you don't feel good, so you're not going to go? Like, that's what you wanted to do this whole time. Yeah.
So this morning is the first morning that I've woken up since I've gotten sick. And I actually feel okay. Like I don't feel like death. Usually in the mornings are just really hard when you're waking up, and this morning I felt all right. So my throat's a little meh.
Mine too.
We're on Valentia Island, which is just across from Port McGee. Also, Star Wars Island is literally boom. So the one on the right is Skellig Michael. Air quotes, Star Wars Island, and the one on the left is Little Skellig.
I see him.
boats. Those are the Skellig Michael boats that we will be on tomorrow. Exciting. The sea is really calm, so hopefully it's like this tomorrow too. Just watched, we saw a couple of boats going out and I'm just really excited about it. Yeah. Oh my gosh, I can't wait. Going through the town of Port McGee now and staying on Skellig Road, and then we're back on the Ring of Kerry for the rest of the day.
Look at this view.
This road just seemingly goes straight up a mountain.
Let's see where this road takes us.
Calling out your name, oh, hiding under the covers with no one else to blame, oh, you couldn't help out your own neighbor, you couldn't tell it to his face, you were fucked up by the blade. You can't worry the code.
We're back on the Ring of Kerry, mm-hmm. off of the Skellig Ring Road. And we're going through the town of Waterville, and Emily just saw this house on the coast. This is ridiculous. Tell me you wouldn't live here. That's a helicopter.
But there's also, there's a couple different flags. I feel like it must be...
Well, there's an Irish flag on top and an American flag, and then there's just like a white flag next to it. I can't tell, but this is definitely like an estate. And it's right next to a golf course.
Someone important.
That's the first
home over there.
Maybe. That house right there?
Yeah.
Who lives in Waterville from America?
I'm gonna go look that up. What official lives here?
No.
Work, 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 work.
We just made another really quick stop along the way. You see that bay out there with the boats and stuff? So what I did was I took the drone.
This is my favorite scenic spot.
We stopped to grab a little lunch there. We haven't eaten yet, but we're also gonna take a look at this, because this seems worth looking at. This is the warmest water
in Ireland.
In Ireland, Carroll's Cove. Just down the road a little bit, and we passed this. And as soon as we passed it and saw that water, we knew we had to turn around. You want to walk down that path right there? Or do you want to walk down to the actual beach?
Let's go down that path first.
Okay.
Let's take the path less traveled. Like we're on the French Riviera.
I know. Yeah. Except there's nobody here. There's literally 10 people on the beach. This water is gorgeous. If I brought a towel, I could jump off right there. Didn't know that I could cliff jump today, so I didn't think to bring a towel.
Then it would be warm enough.
I know. I mean, I'm sure the water's freezing, but I would be so worth it. She's on a mission.
I didn't know we were going rock climbing today.
We are gonna feel this warmest water. Hey, there's more like a gradual steps over here down. Okay. So come back up.
Look at the people swimming. They are full on in this water.
I know. Oh, now the sun's coming back out. We're trying to take a picture. Here's the water test. Just thinking.
I can't reach
you. You can do it. What'd you think?
Oh, it's so warm. It's not horrible, but it's not warm.
Yeah, no. Would you swim in it?
I would jump in and get out.
Is it colder than the springs?
I'd say maybe even with it.
Yeah.
I'm just known to fall a lot, so try not to fall in this water.
Let me move and then you can go.
Okay.
Champion.
I feel like I don't look like a champion climbing rocks. My grass is slippery.
It was bound to happen.
Oh, at least it wasn't in the water.
No, that's true.
Warned me. I'm known to fall.
All right, on with our drive. Steg Fort. Wow, it's big.
You can go all up in it. That's cool.
Yeah, that's so neat. I mean, it really does overlook the bay there too.
Kind of like the beehive.
Yeah. What's in there? Just go underneath it? Gosh.
Ugh. I thought maybe it went all the way through.
I can.
Oh, I can too.
I'm standing up all the way. Wow. That's crazy. Smells like rocks in here.
Wet rocks.
This is awesome. Yeah. Yeah, it's a good lookout from up here.
This is cool. Stream that goes all the way through.
I know. Look at that. That is so beautiful.
I'd say this was the most well-protected one we've found so far.
Yeah, so far. Found this little secret garden down here. Check this out.
A little fairy garden.
I know.
I don't want to walk down.
Look at this. I feel like if I was a kid, this is where I would hide out.
Oh, all the time. This is so cool.
This is awesome. Good
time. Hey!
What do we have left today?
Left today, we have the Glacier Lake. It was a lake carved out by glaciers.
Wow. Okay.
And then we have the sheep farm.
Wait, when is the glacier thing?
That's next.
Is it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sheep. We're seeing a sheep herding exhibition.
Mm-hmm. And then after that, we're going to the Muckross House in Killarney, and then we're doing the Killarney National.
And then we're going to hike, because we need more hikes. This drive has been probably the best drive we've done so far. Which, after the Dangle drive we did, is very hard to do. But
it was done.
It's doing it. So the weather has been good.
Yeah, we had a really sunny moment
on
the coast. And we'll have pictures of it posted on our Instagram, but it was stunning.
Yeah. It's a German tour or something. They're speaking German. Sprechen Sie Deutsch? Welp.
Even though we were diligent and looked on the website, it said the last one was at 4. It is now 3:54, and it just ended.
Need to do better, Kissane Sheep Farm. You need to do better.
Especially since there was a site we could have seen farther back.
Exactly. We kind of skipped something to get here. It looks like it's still going on because people are watching, but...
We only make it the tail end of it.
I don't know how you would have known unless you checked the calendar that you told us to look at.
If there's any complications, then you bring them inside. Okay, other than that, I mean, inside they just tend to breed disease and sickness. You know, they're meant to be outside, so... Yeah.
I wondered the difference.
The sheep, serious damage.
This is the area that all sheep come through for shearing. I know this is John. John will be doing the shearing here. And we shear the sheep now once a year for their health and well-being. So I grew up on the farm and we did the shearing 2 times a year.
Heifer!
Come on, Heifer. And now we do it once a year for their health and well-being. When I came home from school in the evening, that was my job, shearing the sheep by hand. We had no electricity on the farm. I could shear about 20 in the evening. That's what we done. And we were the last place in Ireland to get electricity in 1977. Then he will start the identification of the farm. So every farmer, different colour, different identification. 7 pound weight. It's worth about $2. So in the past there was a big demand for wool for army uniforms, insulating the warships, cruise liners. Now army uniforms are made from cotton synthetic.
That talk was very informational. I learned a lot about sheep and
cool.
wool making and what all the different things that they make from wool. Look at these little babies. Aww.
He wants food.
Look how sweet.
Mm. He thinks we have food.
Look at your little horns. Look at your little horns. Look at your big horns. Look at that. That's a horn and a half right there, man. Could do some damage.
So sweet.
Papa black sheep. He got all the wool. Now watch me whip. Alright, so. Lessons learned today. Number one, this is probably a very worthwhile stop for you in Ireland. Mm-hmm. Just make sure if the calendar says 4, you're here by like 3:30. Because if a tour bus shows up, they're going to take the tour bus in and start the tour. Because they're not going to make 50 people wait.
For two.
So, but other than that, man, they make so much stuff.
Yeah.
All the hand creams and soaps and stuff like that, they make from like the oils of the sheep wool and...
Very interesting.
It's wild. I didn't know any of that.
I didn't either.
I thought they just made sweaters. Walk around for a minute, but I guess we're gonna head on.
Yeah.
Muckross House, actually.
Yeah, we should probably go. A tunnel!
Look how narrow this thing is.
Oh my gosh.
That is a one-lane tunnel.
Ah.
We are almost to the Muckross House. We've got about 30 minutes before the last entry. And we've got maybe 10 minutes to go, I think.
Yeah.
So we should be good.
We should be good. Fingers crossed. Do you want to hear us say it again? There's another beautiful place.
Not going to say it. Apparently the next tour is like 10 after 5, so that's what we're going to do now. And then we're going to try to go back to Killarney Forest and go for the hike.
I guess Queen Victoria. Stayed here for 3 nights.
Wow. This place looks like a dump. Gotta go up.
Yeah, but we could have just taken that shortcut.
Look at this.
Where's the front door? Is this like the Versailles of Ireland?
I guess. Who stayed here?
Queen Victoria.
It's pretty high class. This looks like what, like the house from Cinderella or something.
It also kind of looks like the Haunted Mansion.
We found it.
Second fall.
That was no, that was off camera though. You're lucky. She literally almost fell on her face. Tickets for a guided tour. What is this? What is this? Got your student ID. Got tickets. It's in 1 minute. It starts right in there.
Personally, we can't take you with us.
They seem pretty strict here. So, alright, we're gonna go ahead and start it, and then we're gonna walk the gardens. We can't video the tour, but we just finished, so we're gonna video the signing of the guest book. Also, I feel like I just had a really immense history lesson. If you come here, you should do the tour in this house. It was really good. Did you like it?
I loved it.
I thought the lady was great. I learned so much, and she was a fantastic guide. So it's like 50 minutes, and it was really cheap, too.
Really small tour, informative, casual.
All right, we're gonna tour the gardens now.
Yeah.
And then I got the hangar.
And then I'm hungry too. Just had soup for lunch, and you didn't have that much either.
Yeah. Restaurant, shop, crafts, and gardens that way. All right. That was great. I really enjoyed that.
Yeah, it was like really well preserved. But I loved how informal it was, and they were like,
yes,
please look at it. Like, don't touch it, but like,
it just wasn't a stuffy tour. It was just, you know.
I appreciate it. They're not everything being so blocked off and security driven.
Yeah.
It just,
it was
nice.
What's up there? So apparently Queen Victoria came here because her son was in the military and was commissioned here. And he wrote to her saying that she needed to come and visit because it's like a fairyland. Which, I mean, I pretty much agree. It doesn't even seem real. It seems like you're walking through like Disney or something, and it's been manicured like on purpose. When you're driving through the forest, it just
like,
doesn't even...
This is a fake rock.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I wonder how often like the people who actually lived here like in walked this like enjoyed it. Like did they ever? I don't know. This is just casually my backyard.
I feel like it's you know, like it has touches of like a Versailles or something like that, but it's just not as stuffy.
Yeah.
You know, it's way more relaxed. Like you just can come here and I love Versailles. Versailles is one of my favorite places, really.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I love it.
Those gardens.
The gardens there are fantastic, but there's just nobody here. It's not crowded. It doesn't, it just has a totally different feel to it. I don't know. How is it?
No, there you go.
All right.
Thank you.
There we go.
Hello. This literally tastes like a little bit richer than frozen whipped cream. Like, it's so creamy.
I can't wait to try this. This is the first time I've ever had something like this, ever.
I've never had ice cream like this.
It's butter in a cone. And like an actual chocolate stick that you just eat. This is the best thing ever. It's like light. It's not a heavy, like, soft serve. Parking lot?
Waterfall.
It's my kind of hike.
Yeah.
Hike 5 minutes, see all the cool stuff, turn around and come back. This is Killarney National Forest. This is not the Torque Waterfalls.
We just saw other people that we saw at the same restaurant we were eating at in Dingle. And it's just crazy how when you're touristing a place, you can just run into people and different...
Dingle is like... 3 hours away.
And we're at the Ring of Kerry, where there's a lot of different stops on the Ring of Kerry.
And the National Forest.
We just so happen to walk past them.
Yeah, the Ring of Kerry basically takes the day to do. I don't think they recognized us, though. I think they just kept walking.
I don't know.
It was pretty here.
Small world.
I would walk for more than 5 minutes in this forest.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Somebody go up to your brother. He's calling out your name. Oh, oh. Hiding under the covers with no one else to blame. Oh, oh, oh.
Literally just climbed that waterfall.
Just sitting here now on this rock. It's so pretty. This water is amazing.
I know. It's so clear. I really want to jump in. Like, I wish it was warm so I could swim.
I wonder how cold this is. He's going in. The guy had an extra pair of shorts on him. He just went for it. All right. You ready to go?
Yeah.
Going back down to the car. So we are basically on the opposite side of the ring from where we are staying tonight. So we have a bit of a hike back the way we came, just because we already did the other side of the ring earlier. But we're gonna go ahead and say goodnight here. Just because, again, we're just going to be driving back the same way. Tomorrow is kind of like it's the capstone day for me, honestly. Like, I don't want to put all my hopes on it, just because it is weather dependent, but it is one of the humongous reasons why I wanted to come here and do this. So, really hoping that the weather's going to be great tomorrow and we're going to get to go. If we get to go, like rain or shine, I'm going to be thrilled. Like, it won't matter. But tomorrow after we do Skellig, we get back pretty early and we'll be checked out of our Airbnb, and then we're going to take a little country road back to a city called Tralee. We'll spend the night in Tralee. We turn the rental car in and then we catch the train back to Dublin for a night. So, and then we're home.
Oh my gosh, that just really made me panic a little bit.
We have Skellig tomorrow. Hold on to that. Okay. So we will say goodnight. See you guys.
Goodnight.
You couldn't have out your own neighbor. You couldn't tell it to his face. You were fucked up by the blade.